The first step in working with a list in C# is to declare the list. The way we do that is we use the keyword list first, followed by the data type. We'll start with an integer example. After that is the list name itself. We'll use numbers here like we did in the last lesson. Then we have to call the constructor for the list class. So we type new list, again the data type, and then a set of open and closed parentheses. Once again, the keyword list, followed by the data type, followed by the list name, equal sign for the constructor call, and then new list, again the data type, and open close parentheses. Let's look at a couple other examples from other data types. So we can use string here, or we could have Boolean, or char. And those are all different ways to declare a list. Now, a couple of things that don't really involve the declaration of a list, but some things you need to know. When you declare a list, you're not actually creating any size for the list. The way we can tell that is by calling the count property. In the last lesson, I used parentheses after count, which you can do, or you can use it without parentheses where it becomes a property rather than a method. Both ways work in C#. C# kind of combines old ways from earlier versions of .NET with things that you're used to seeing in Java. But we can call count like this. Let's add a little description here. There we go. And now let's run this program. And it says the number of items in numbers is 0. And that's because all we did was declare numbers without actually giving it any size. A list size is only increased when we add items into the list. There's no other way to increase the size. There is one other property called capacity. Capacity tells the compiler that you want to initially have 10 items in the list. Let me explain how that works. Every time you add an item to a list, the capacity of the list grows by 1. You can make your list more efficient by initially setting the capacity to however many items you think is going to be in the list. If I know my list is going to have 10 items, then by setting the capacity to 10, the compiler won't allocate space every single time I add a new item. Only after the 10th item is added, then new capacity has to be allocated. So while you don't have to set the capacity of a list, and in a lot of the examples I'm going to show in this chapter, I won't, to save a little bit of time, you can do so and save a little bit of efficiency. But again, it's not necessary to do that. But even setting the capacity doesn't change anything. If we look at the size again by calling count, we'll see that that hasn't changed. The only way we can change the size or change the count is by adding items into the list. So the main thing to know about declaring a list is that you need to know the data type, which you put in angle brackets, and that you have to call the constructor with syntax like you see highlighted there. And that works for all the built-in data types, and it would work for data types you create. And we'll see how to do that when we create classes later on in the course. We'll create lists of our class objects in which we use our user-defined data type instead of a built-in data type. So that wraps up this lesson on declaring arrays, and let's move now to the next item of importance, and that's how to initialize a list once you've declared it.